Today we're going to talk about the concept of urban metabolism and how we can use this to analyze and design our cities. Imagine the city as if it is a living organism or an ecosystem in which different flows come together, like water, energy, food, people, etc. Let me show you what I mean by using the example of the city of Delft and one of its flows, water. Well, in order to be able to do this, I first need to explain you something about the water system in the Netherlands in general. The main defense line of the Netherlands from the sea are the dunes. Behind these dunes, there's peat, a very soft soil that contains a lot of water. So the groundwater is very high. In order to make this land suitable for inhabitation and agriculture, people started to dig canals and ditches to be able to discharge the water from these canals to the rivers that discharge into the sea. As a consequence of this drainage, the land started to subside. Imagine this soft soil as if it is a sponge and you squeeze the water out. This means it will shrink. This is an irreversible and self-enforcing process. So, the land subsides. Canals need to be dug deeper. Dikes need to be made. And pumping stations need to pump up the water to the higher level rivers constantly in order to be able to discharge it to the sea. So as a consequence, Delft and a large part of the Netherlands is now below sea level and needs to be drained constantly. As a consequence of this level difference, there is a water quality problem because there is a rising groundwater pressure, forcing more saline water to mix with the freshwater just below the surface. Climate change causes sea level rise, increasing this pressure. This means that there's also a risk of the polder giving in and flooding with groundwater from below. Well, that's not the only threat that climate change poses. Climate change also causes more annual precipitation and periods of heavy rainfall. As the pumping station's capacity might not be sufficient, this means that the polder may drown with water from the canals, but also from the rivers. Furthermore, sewage system spillage may occur, causing quality problems of the surface water. Another threat that climate change poses are increased periods of drought during summer. Again, subsidence may occur, increasing the level difference between sea and polder. The dikes may lose their stability, collapsing and again flooding the polder with water. The warming of the water can again cause water quality problems. So imagine that here is a city. For example, the city of Delft, having to cope with all of these problems. Let me show you how they do this by using the example of one of its polders, not the entire city. Here's a map of the city. This is the historic city center. Here you see the main drainage canal connecting Delft to rivers and to the sea. And just east of this historic city center is the Beeslandse Bovenpolder, existing of two subsystems, and I will now look into this urban system. So, this is a page from the water plan of the water board of the municipality, and it shows you very conceptually how they will cope with the problems they have in this polder, which is mainly a shortage of water storage capacity, but also water quality problems. So here we see the urban part of the Beeslandse Bovenpolder. What they propose to do is a mix of solutions. The first one is to disconnect this polar system from the main discharge canal. So only in case of emergency, they will pump out or let in water from the main system, which is often more polluted. They will also add extra surface water, so extra ponds, but also widening of existing canals. They will remove missing links and dead ends so that it can circulate, which improves water quality. And they will also make ecological embankments, which have very slow slopes and have a lot of different plants which purify the water, but also add to this water storage capacity. Here we can see it in the map. Again, the historic city center of Delft, and this the Beeslandse Bovenpolder. In orange, we see the new connections that have to make sure that the water can circulate. In green, the ecological embankments, and in purple, missing links underground that make sure that the whole system is connected. Well, you can see that in this approach, water is seen as a flow with inputs and outputs. It is a system in which inputs and outputs are also connected. And several solutions are combined to make it a sustainable system. Well, it's important that designers look at the city as an ecosystem, as they are responsible also for the design of the city and its flows. And we will have to, considering the challenges we face. In the case of Delft, water problems, but in other countries it might be food shortage because of drought or air pollution, because of traffic congestion, soil pollution because of drilling, where there are so many problems, and we as designers should contribute to solving them using the concept of urban metabolism.